Today is, I have to look at my calendar. Day 8 of May We Draw Daily. I already mentioned this a bunch of times, but for anybody who's not familiar with it, what it is every day for the month of May, you want to draw something, produce some kind of art. So I'm just gonna play around today and let's see what we come up with. I'm gonna use this stencil here from Jane Davenport. This, I believe, comes with one of her acrylic sets. So that's what we're gonna play with today. So I got some watercolors here. I got a paintbrush, just a cup of water, and my Jane Davenport watercolor sketchbook. I'm almost done with this, guys. I can't believe it. It's the fastest I ever went through a sketch pad. Right, so let's just go ahead and get into this. I'm gonna go ahead and just wet the paper a little bit. A lot of it. I'm just gonna go ahead and drop some colors onto this wet paper. So I'm just dropping it and letting it do what it does. Try not to be too loud. My kids finally fell asleep. So this is my little time to make a video and do some art. All right, so I'm just picking up paint and just dabbing it at different places. Now I'm just cleaning up my brush. Still has water. And I'm actually gonna go ahead and get some dripping going on. You guys can move your paper around to move the watercolors. Let's make a big puddle. Let's do some purple. Put some more pink. So you guys can let this dry like this and let it, mix or whatever. You guys can get paper towel or something and dab it in places where where you feel like it's getting muddy or whatnot, or to get a lighter effect. But I'm gonna use my blow dryer and dry this. Color. you guys can see this puddle here, but I'm just gonna dry off my brush and lift that puddle up with the dry brush. I'm gonna go ahead and dry this and I'll be right back. Alright guys, so this is what I'm left with after drying the watercolor paints that I put down with the blow dryer. Alright, so let's see. I'm gonna use my Jane Davenport Incredible Pen. And I'm gonna place the stencil we'll do it like here. I don't want to do it this way because I don't want the eyes to be distorted, the face to be distorted, so I'll do it here. So I'm just going to fill in. Typically, I would never buy stencils or anything or stamps, but these were really cheap at Michael's. I found them for $5.99, and then of course, you know, if you use a coupon, you get it for even less than that. So I decided to grab it and try it out, and I really like this, especially for like times where I don't want to be serious and like draw too much. Alright, so I'm just filling this in. Alright, and that's what we're left with. Alright, so now I'm going to use this as a guide, and I'm just going to go ahead and sometimes this pen really irritates me, but I love it. I'm just going to try to clean the nib a little bit, see if I can get it to run better. Alright, so I'm just using these lines as guidelines. So you guys can just use the stencil for guidelines and draw your own features or whatnot. Or you can just go ahead and use what's on there. Make her lips bigger. But you guys can use stencils and make it your own. Put your own little twist, flair to it. Let's draw her an earring. Let's see how we're gonna do her hair. Let's do her hair like that. So I'm gonna go ahead and block in some shadows. Thank you. All right, so I'm gonna take a water brush. And if anyone's not familiar with what a water brush is, it's just a brush that you fill with water and you paint with, that's it. So this ink that I'm using is water soluble ink. This ink isn't moving like I want to, but that's all right. I'm gonna make do. So I'm just adding shading to where that's the paper coming up. To where I think the shadow should be. So I want to add more here in these areas that are white. I'm gonna put more watercolor. I'm just gonna go ahead and use my water brush for that. So I'm gonna push out a little bit of water from my water brush and wet this. Let's just get it wet. And when you guys switch colors, wipe off the color that you're using with the paper towel. So I'm squeezing while I'm laying down some color. It off and grab some yellow. Here is too dark, so I'm gonna dab some of that. Alright, guys, I'm gonna dry this and come right back. This is what it looks like after it's dry. So while that's drying, I'm gonna go ahead and use some acrylic paints. Actually, let me draw her some shoulders so she's not just floating off the page. Do that. This is a technique I've seen a lot of people use. I actually did it with my kids the other week. I'm gonna share that with you guys. Sorry if I sound too low. I don't want my kids to wake up. So this is what I've been seeing everywhere. So I watercolored this the way that I did this. I drew the flowers and then I blocked it in with acrylic and I went over it with some gold metallic watercolor. And I had my kids do it with me. This is my younger daughter. And this is my oldest. So this is a really fun project to do. So I decided to try it with a face. So I just used a little bit of Jane Davenport's acrylic paint, this blue color. Looks like a lot, I don't know. Hmm. Now I'm gonna grab a flat brush. Where's the one that I was using yesterday? So now I'm using a flat brush and I'm just gonna go ahead and paint around everything that I drew. Grab some of that, put it here. I'm gonna wet my brush a little. And this acrylic paint is matte acrylic paint, so it's not going to be shiny or glossy or what have you. I should have really put a paper under here. Alright, I'm going to do this side before it dries out. Alright guys, I don't want to make this video too long, so I'm going to go ahead and time lapse the rest, and I'll come back at the end. Alright guys, so this is what I came up with. I used my Gold Fine Tech watercolors to do these swirls, flourish things. Did some splatter. I used a Posca pen to do some of these white splatters. I use my Jane Davenport paint over pen to do some highlights on eyes and lips. And yeah, that's it for this video. I hope that you guys enjoy. Something not so serious, playing around, but still creating and drawing. Yeah, so I'll see you guys next time.